If they hatin', got a price to pay. California on my license plate. Last year, they ain't even like the bay. Damn, but we don't never trip. All of those guys break
this. Hey, what's going on, YouTube? BDKane721. Hope everybody's doing well on this Wednesday morning, 29th of November. I'm excited to bring you this video today. I get to officially announce to everyone that my 2023 Topps Chrome Purple Speckle set is done. I have officially received all the remaining cards. I think there's 13 of them here that I need to put into this binder. And I'm gonna flip the camera around and show you that process as I normally do, so that you can see the product, see what it looks like all together. It's fantastic. I love the binder idea. As you know, this is the first year in a long time that I've started to put these cards in a binder, and I think that's what I'm gonna do from this point forward. So I do like it in the binder format. But I wanted to talk first about the set, how it compares to previous years, some stats, because I think maybe some of you out there are kind of interested in understanding a little bit more about the process and what it took for me to get this set completed. You've probably seen this table before. I know I've shown it on the channel before. This is my tracker sheet of all the sets that I've been working on since 2011. As you know, I've been doing this numbered refractor set adventure since 2011. This 2023 set is set number 18 on this list that has been completed. There are still a few other sets on this list that I'm trying to complete, but this one's number 18. Two of those sets are non-Topps Chrome sets. There's a Gypsy Queen and a Finest set. So that means I have 16 Topps Chrome numbered refractor sets completely done. Exciting. It's unbelievable when I look at that and think about everything that I went through to get those sets done. But I'm pretty excited about it. Pretty proud of that. And I'm going to hopefully continue on into the future. For 2023, if you've been watching my videos, you'll know that speed was the primary focus. I was trying to get this done as quickly as possible. So of course, when you're trying to get something like this done as quickly as possible, you're gonna sacrifice some other things. It took me about 4 months to do it. Topps Chrome came out at the end of July at the National, if I remember correctly, which was the end of July. So you've got August, September, October, and now November. So it's 4 months. The last card came in on Monday, so almost about 4 months to the day when Topps Chrome came out. So that's really fast. Normally it goes past the first of the year. I'm into February, March, trying to get the last few cards, but I was able to do it that quickly. So I'm really happy about that. But of course, I had to sacrifice cost. Cost was a little higher than normal. I've got my little, tracker sheet for this set, and $9.91 per card. Remember, that includes shipping. Most of these cards, probably 99% of these cards, I had to get through eBay and ComC. So shipping was included in that cost. My top 10 cards, from a cost perspective, was almost $800 this year. That's a ton. There are years in the past where $800 was what I spent on the entire set. And some years, at the very, very beginning, it was maybe half of that I spent on the set. So times have changed. No question about it, times have changed. 2022 was about $7 a card, but I had 8 cards in that set that were either traded for or I was donated by some great people in the community. This year, I only had 1 card donated to me, which is a little unusual. Not donated, I think that one card was traded for, which I count as a zero towards the total because it's hard for me to really identify the cost of the cards that I traded. So I count it as a zero for these purposes. And so when you go from having right around half a dozen to 10 cards a year that you get through trades and people donating them to your adventure, it can really raise the cost. So anyway, last year, 2022, $7 a card, 8 cards were traded or donated to me. 2021, interestingly enough, was $9.33 a card, and I still had 7 cards donated or traded. So that set seemed to be a little bit on par with this current set. So, but it really gets interesting when you hear the next stat. I went back to really early years to see what I was paying. I was keeping track of it back then. In 2013, I paid an average of about $2.50 a card, and that included shipping. And in that year, 49 cards were either traded to me, donated to me, or I opened in boxes. You know, these last several years, I don't open boxes or cases anymore, really. Maybe one per year. And if I'm lucky, I'll get a card out of that for the set, but typically I don't. But back then, I was opening cases of cards and boxes of cards almost every week. So 49 of them came in that form. And they didn't get counted towards the cost of the per card cost of the set. So a lot less money that I spent last time. I would go to shows. I went to my first national in 2012 in Baltimore. There were several tables that had these types of cards in their showcases, in their value boxes. There was one dealer I can remember specifically from that show in Baltimore that had just piles of numbered refractors from Topps Chrome that I was able to sift through. I came away, there's probably even a video on my channel still that summarizes that particular show. I should look for that and put that up on my channel just for historical purposes. But that's where I'm at with this one. And I think that I did really well speed-wise, cost-wise, definitely a lot higher. I could have spent that money on a lot of other things. I know that I've gotten comments over the years from people that why not spend that money on something else? But this is what I do. It's so much fun to me. It brings me back to my youth when I was putting sets together. I'm not gonna change. I mean, as long as I can afford it, my wife doesn't get angry at me, I'm just gonna continue to do it. It's a lot of fun. So I hope you guys enjoy it. I'm gonna flip the camera around and show you the final product and move on to the next adventure in the collection. All right, I'll be back in a sec. All right, everyone, thanks for hanging in there. I'm gonna show you the final product here, show you what cards I have in this final group. A lot of heavy hitters as far as cost goes in this group because, like I said in one of my previous videos, that there were several mid-range rookie cards still left, like Anthony Volpe, Nolan Jones, James Outman, and then some veterans, Giancarlo Stanton, another rookie, Ruiz, Luis Robert, Oswald Peraza, Mountcastle, really nice Bobby Witt Jr. That was a difficult card to get at a good price. Castellanos, Ozzy Albies, Francisco Alvarez was another tough one, and Kodai Senga. So a lot of really good rookies in there. I don't know how they'll pan out in years to come, but at least right now they're going for a decent price. So I'm going to go ahead and put these into the binder and speed up the process here a little bit so you don't have to sit around watching that. All right, here we go. All right, I hope you enjoyed that. I know that was quicker than normal, but there it is. It is done. Every page, 9 cards, complete numbered refractor set. All these cards are numbered to $299. Purple speckle variety. I just can't say enough about how great it is to get all of these cards together in one spot, and it'll be fun to put this up on the shelf and come back and look at them every once in a while to see how some of the rookies are doing and a lot of the veterans, especially a lot of the veterans that are going to hit the Hall of Fame, like Verlander and some other ones in here. Albert Pujols, definite Hall of Famer. So things of that nature. It'll be a lot of fun. And I just wanted to show you the final product in its binder format, which is what I'll be doing moving forward instead of putting them into top loaders into my Little Beast. Little Beast is probably going to be sold and moved on to somebody else. And the last card in the set is Paul Goldschmidt, card number 220. I do have some extra binder sheets in here that I need to probably take out. But that's it. So on to the next adventure. Can't wait till next year, which probably will happen right around the National again. And thank you to everybody who helped me get this set together. I really appreciate everything that everybody does for me and all the encouragement. And again, looking forward to next year and looking forward to more adventures in the future. All right, guys, talk to you soon. See you.